got bonus boards up here, cuz why not? Go smash them all. I'm serious. I can't remember where we hit them.
safe to do so.
Turn left.
left. Turn left.
Thank you.
yards, turn sharp right.
We'll be right back.
turn around when it is safe to do so.
So, where's our special guest? The Hot Wheels expert.
Haven't figured it out yet, have you? Get in! Just look at this place. It's like a childhood dream come true. I thought I'd bring along a few friends who wanted to show off their Hot Wheels inspired cars. So, I've got some fact sheets here. You get to learn along with the audience. I'll just hit the record button and... Stick with me, kid. The biggest Hot Wheels expert on Earth is about to take you to school. It all started with Elliot Handler, who saw the toy cars his son played with and thought to himself, I could make something better. You see, right from the very beginning, Elliot envisioned a toy car that looked cool and rolled fast, making it that much more fun to play with. At the time, there was nothing out there like that. Handler brought in former rocket engineer Jack Ryan and General Motors car designer Harry Bradley to help. And between them, they made the first 16 cars, known as the Original 16. Jack's team developed the stainless steel axles and Delrin hubs that allowed the cars to roll super fast, while Harry made them look super eye-catching. Harry and Jack's contributions became the pillars of Hot Wheels, performance and design. The first car off the production line was a custom Camaro, a lot like the one you're driving right now.
There.
Yeah, and another of the original 16 was the custom Fleetside, based on Harry's custom Chevy El Camino. Most of those early designs are inspired by hot rods and muscle cars, which were popular in California car culture at the time. After Harry Bradley, more designers joined the team, like Ira Guilford from Chrysler, who did the twin mill, and Larry Wood from Ford, who designed the original Bone Shaker. But right from the beginning, they were designing cars to do one thing above all: roll really, really fast on plastic tracks.
You've done your research.
Research? I memorized this stuff when I was 6 years old. One reason why Hot Wheels are so eye-catching is because of a special paint called Spectral Flame. They use a transparent lacquer applied over a polished zinc plating, which gave it a totally awesome metallic effect, just like a real car. Since then, Hot Wheels has broadened and developed its paint techniques to support a variety of looks and effects. Fascinating stuff, right? Another detail was the red stripe on the tyres, like the one you're driving now. They called them Redline tyres, and they look so cool! Redline tyres are a defining characteristic of this era and are really sought after by collectors. Drive. Here, take the Nash Custom 1957, winner of the Legends Tour 2019.
Thanks, Hayley. Hey, let's do this again soon.
Driving right now.
See what you did there?
Yeah! And another of the original 16 was the custom Fleetside, based on Harry's custom Chevy El Camino. Most of those early designs were inspired by hot rods and muscle cars, which were popular in California car culture at the time. After Harry Bradley, more designers joined the team, like Ira Guilford from Chrysler, who did the twin mill, and Larry Wood from Ford, who designed the original Bone Shaker. But right from the beginning, they were designing cars to do one thing above all, roll really, really fast on plastic tracks.
You've done your research.
Research? I memorized this stuff when I was 6 years old. One reason why Hot Wheels are so eye-catching is because of a special paint called Spectraflame. They use a transparent lacquer applied over a polished zinc plating, which gave it a totally awesome metallic effect. Just like a real car, since then Hot Wheels has broadened and developed its paint techniques to support a variety of looks and effects. Fascinating stuff, right? Another detail was the red stripe on the tyres, like the one you're driving now. They called them Redline tyres, and they look so cool! Redline tyres are a defining characteristic of this era and are really sought after by collectors. Drive. Here, take the Nash Custom 1957, winner of the Legends Tour 2019.
Thanks, Hayley. Hey, let's do this again soon.
LA called. You're ready for the next qualifier. Don't want to keep her waiting. Complete this and I'll upgrade your rank to pro. I'll let Alejandro know you're on the way. Go on, amigo.
I was looking through Haley's old Hot Wheels catalogs and I might have something, but I need you down here, like, right now. 200 yards, turn left. Turn left. Turn around when it is safe to do so.
Haley says she's always wanted to see what this thing can do on this scale. So for that, I think we need to take it surfing. For your next qualifier, you'll need to prove you can take on the water flumes at high speed. Let's go. Hit it! Remember, surfing is all about balance. First flume coming right up. Keep going. Take the speed boost to the top and skip the queue. Okay, next flume coming right up. Remember, you want to move with the water, not against it. Looks like you're going back to school at the academy. You're a pro rank now. Oh, and you can keep the Diora.
You made it through the qualifier. You are now officially an academy pro. I've added all the new events to your schedule. Something tells me you're gonna love these. How would you like to learn a bit more about Hot Wheels? Wanna learn about the famous orange track?
Absolutely. Be there soon.